Hi everyone, it's me again, Titser Jay, and welcome to another episode of Learning. So, ngayong araw, ang i-discuss natin ay solving quadratic equation by completing the square. So, natapos na natin yung extracting square roots and factoring. So, those methods po are usually used to solve quadratic equations of the form. Kagaya last time, sabi ko, ax squared is equal to c. And yung, that is extracting square root. And yung factoring naman, we can use factoring if the quadratic equation is factorable. Okay? So, another method in solving quadratic equation is by completing the square. So, magagamit din natin si completing the square kapag yung ating quadratic equation ay hindi siya factorable. So, there are some steps to follow para mag-solve ng quadratic equation by completing the square. Again, we have steps to follow in solving quadratic equation by completing the square. First one, divide both sides of the equation by a, then simplify if necessary. Number two, write the equation such that the terms with variables are on the left side of the equation and the constant term is on the right side. Third, add the square of 1/2 of the coefficient of x on both sides of the resulting equation. The left side of the equation becomes a perfect square trinomial. Fourth, express the perfect square trinomial on the left side of the equation as a square of a binomial. Fifth, solve the resulting quadratic equation by extracting the square root. Six, solve the resulting linear equations. So those are the six, or these are the six steps on how to solve quadratic equation by completing the square. Okay, for you to understand well, let's have this first example. Solve x squared plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. So, kung titingnan natin yung ating quadratic equation, pwede siyang gamitan ng factoring. Kasi itong quadratic equation na ito ay factorable. Sige, solve muna natin itong equation na ito using factoring. Mamaya po yung completing the square. So, ang gagawin muna natin, x squared, rewrite muna natin yung equation, x squared plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. So, kung napanood nyo yung video ka last time about factoring, pwede nyo pong i-post yung video and then i-solve yung ating equation. So, first step na gagawin natin is i-factor natin yung x squared. So, ganito yung ginawa natin last time. Ayan. Next, kunin din natin yung factors ng 6. So, yung factors ng 6, pwedeng 2, tsaka 3. Pwedeng 6 and 1. And then, etong factors na ito, dito sa dalawang factors na ito, tingnan natin dyan, kapag pinag-add natin yung factors na yan, ang makukuha natin is yung middle term, which is yung 5. Okay? So, try natin, 2 plus 3, that is equal to 5. 6 plus 1, that is equal to 7. So, ang tama dyan na factors ay 2 at saka 3. So, that is x plus 2 and then x plus 3 is equal to 0. Next, using zero product property or yung ZPP, we are going to equate the factors into 0. So, this is x plus 2 is equal to 0. Yung isa naman, x plus 3 is equal to 0. So, by using subtraction property of equality, or this is x plus 2 minus 2 is equal to 0 minus 2. So this is x, 2 minus 2 that is equal to 0, and then 0 minus 2 that is negative 2. Same with this equation, using subtraction property of equality, this is x plus 3 minus 3 is equal to 0 minus 3. And then this is x, 0 yan, is equal to 0 minus 3, that is negative 3. Or you can simply transpose this one, this positive 3 to right side, it becomes negative 3. So the solution or roots of this quadratic equation, let's say this is x sub 1 and this is x sub 2. Again, the solutions or roots of this quadratic equation, x squared plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0, are negative 2 and negative 3. So, itong quadratic equation na ito ay factorable. So, pwedeng ang gagamitin natin ay factoring. Pero, itong quadratic equation na ito ay pwede rin masolve using the method completing the square. So, tandaan natin, ang sagot natin dito ay negative 2 at saka negative 3. So, we will use this completing the square to solve this quadratic equation. Tingnan natin kung same sila ng sagot. Okay? So, we will solve this quadratic equation by completing the square. So, first step is we are going to divide A, both sides of the equation, or divide both sides of the equation by A, then simplify if necessary. So, i-rewrite muna natin yung ating quadratic equation. X squared plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. So, ang value naman ng A natin dito is 1. So, hindi na kailangan natin mag-divide both sides of the equation by A. Okay? Kasi kapag nag-divide tayo ng 1 dyan, same lang din naman yung makukuha natin, which is x squared plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. Second step, we are going to write the equation such that the terms with variables are on the left side of the equation and the constant term is on the right side. Ibig sabihin, ihiwalay natin yung may variable na terms and then yung walang variable naman ay nasa right side. So, ang may variables lang dito is yung x squared plus 5x. So, x squared plus 5x. And then, yung walang variable or yung constant term natin ay ilipat natin sa kabilang equation. So, this is equal to negative 6 na po siya. Okay? So, x squared plus 5x is equal to negative 6. Third step. We are going to add the square of 1 half of the coefficient of x on both sides of the resulting equation. And then, the left side of the equation becomes a perfect square trinomial. So, ang gagawin muna natin dito is, gagawin natin itong perfect square trinomial. So, ibig sabihin, mag-a-add tayo dito ng number, dito yan, para maging perfect square trinomial. So, paano maglagay ng number dito para maging perfect square trinomial? So, para malagyan natin yan, we will use this formula. B over 2 quantity squared, or square of B divided by 2. So, ang gagawin natin, since ang value ng B natin dyan is 5, so this is 5 over 2. Tama. And then, square natin. Okay? So, simplify natin ito. Square of 5 over 2, this is 25 over 4. Ayan. So, this is 25 over 4. So, this is 25 over 4. Again, para makakuha or makuha natin ito or para maging perfect square trinomial ito, ang ginawa natin is we use this formula, yung square of b over 2. Ang value ng b natin is 5, kaya 5 over 2 na siya, and then squared. Simplify natin, square of 5 over 2, so that is 5 squared, that is equal to 25, and then square of 2 or 2 squared, that is equal to 4, kaya 25 over 4. Kapag nag-add din tayo dito ng 25 over 4, mag-a-add din tayo sa kabila ng 25 over 4. Ganun din ang gagawin natin sa kabilang equation. So, next, gagawin natin itong perfect square trinomial na ito, gagawin natin siyang square of a binomial. Paano natin gagawin square of a binomial ito? So, ang gagawin natin, kunin natin ang square root ng x squared, that is x. Again, para maging square of a binomial ito, kunin natin yung square root ng x squared, that is equal to x, plus, kasi plus yung ating middle term, or positive, square root ng 25 over 4. Square root ng 25, that is equal to 5. Square root ng 4, that is equal to 2. And then, lagyan natin ng square. So, kaya naging square of a binomial na siya. Or square of x plus 5 over 2 is equal to, i-add natin ito, negative 6 plus 25 over 4. So, para ma-add yan, getting the LCD, which is 4. And then, 4 divided, ang LCD nito is 1. 4 divided by 1, that is 4. Times negative 6, that is negative 24. Plus, plus 4 divided by 4, that is 1, times 25, that is equal to 25. Or this is 1 over 4. Okay? 1 over 4 na yan. Moring na lang natin. So, this is 1/4. Okay? So, meron tayong equation, square of x plus 5 over 2 is equal to 1/4. So, kung maalala nyo yung extracting square root na ganito yung form, so we will use extracting square root or extracting the square root on both sides. Again, so square root of square of x plus 5 over 2, that is equal to x plus 5 over 2. Okay, is equal to square root plus minus square root ng 1, that is equal to 1, square root ng 4, that is equal to 2. Ayan. So, positive, negative, 1/2. Next na gagawin natin ay isosolve na ngayon natin yung ating linear equation. So, ililipat natin yung 5/2 sa kabila, sa right side. So, let's say this is our x sub 1 now. X sub 1. So, kapag nilipat natin yan, magiging negative 5 over 2. Okay? And then, wala mo x sub 1. Plus minus 1/2. Ayan. Again, nilipat ko yung 5 over 2 sa right side of sa right side ng ating equation. So, solve na natin ngayon yung x sub 1. Negative 5 over 2. Tapos, gagamitin natin yung plus muna. Plus 1/2. Negative 5 over 2 plus 1/2, that is equal to negative 4 over 2. Tama? Ayan. So, since similar fraction yan, just copy the denominator and then subtract the numerator. Negative 5 plus 1, that is negative 4. Simplify natin, negative 4 divided by 2, that is negative 2. Next, yung x sub 2 naman. So, this is negative 5 over 2. Since nagamit na natin yung plus, minus naman. So, minus 1/2. So, negative 5 over 2 minus 1/2. Copyin lang natin yung denominator. Ayan, which is 2. And then, subtract natin yung exponent. Negative, yung ating numerator. Negative 5 minus 1, that is negative 6. Okay? And then, simplify natin yan, that is negative 3. So, as you can see, same lang yung nakuha nating sagot kanina nung ginamit natin yung factoring. So, this is on how to use or on how to solve quadratic equation by completing the square. So, madali lang yan kapag alam nyo yung steps ng pagsosolve ng quadratic equation by completing this square. Okay, let's have example number 2. Solve x squared plus 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. So, as you can see in this quadratic equation, hindi siya factorable. Ibig sabihin, hindi siya pwedeng gamitan ng factoring. So, we will use completing this square to solve this quadratic equation. So, i-write muna natin yung ating quadratic equation. X squared plus 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. So, next step na gagawin natin is, i-divide down natin both sides of the equation by a, then simplify kung kailangan lang naman. So, since ang value ng a natin dito ay 1, so hindi na pwedeng kailangan mag-divide both sides of the equation by 1. Kasi kapag nag-divide ka pa ng 1, same lang din yung makukuha mong sagot, which is x squared plus 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. So, next na gagawin natin is, i-separate natin yung terms na may variable, dapat nasa left side. And then, yung walang variable naman, or yung constant term natin, dapat nasa right side. So, this is x squared plus 2x is equal to, kapag nilipat natin yan, magiging positive 5. Next, mag-a-add tayo ng number dito para ito ay magiging perfect square trinomial. So, para makapaglagay tayo dito ng number, we will use this formula, b over 2 quantity squared, or square of b over 2. Since by substitution tayo, ang value ng b dito is positive 2, so this is 2 divided by 2 and then square. And then 2 divided by 2, that is 1. 1 square, that is equal to 1. So mag-add tayo ng 1 dyan. Kapag nag-add tayo ng 1 dito, mag-a-add din tayo ng 1 sa kabila. Next, yung x squared plus 2x plus 1, gagawin nating square of a binomial. So para maging square of a binomial ito, kunin lang natin yung square root ng x squared, which is x, plus, kasi plus yung ating middle term or positive, square root ng 1, that is equal to 1. And then square. Kaya meron na tayong square of x plus 1. So, square of a binomial na yan. Is equal to 5 plus 1, that is equal to 6. Next, using extracting the square root. So, extracting the square root on both sides of the equation. Square root of square of x plus 1, that is equal to x plus 1. Okay, makakancel po yan. Okay. Next, is equal to square root of 6. 6 is not a perfect square. Hindi rin siya, factorable siya, pero wala sa mga factors niya ay perfect square. So, ang sagot lang natin dyan is positive negative square root of 6. Again, yung 6 po ay hindi siya perfect square. Factorable yung 6, pero wala sa mga factors niya, o wala sa factors niya ay perfect square. Okay? So, next na gagawin natin is, ililipat natin yung positive 1 to right side. So, magiging x is equal to negative 1 plus minus or positive negative square root of 6. So, sir, paano yan? Paano malalaman yung values or roots ng ating quadratic equation? So, yung x sub 1 natin dyan, this is x sub 1, negative 1, plus yung gagamitin natin, plus square root of 6. Ito na yung ating x sub 1. So, hindi na pwedeng may i-add yung negative 1 plus square root of 6. Pwedeng may i-add siya using your scientific calculator, magiging decimal na siya. So, pwede naman po ito yung ating final answer na. And then yung x sub 2 naman, negative 1, minus naman yung gagamitin natin, minus square root of 6. This is now our x sub 2. So again, kapag kinalki nyo po ito, magiging decimal siya or fraction. Okay? So, these are the solutions or the solutions of this quadratic equation x squared plus 2x minus 5 is equal to 0 are negative 1 plus square root of 6 and negative 1 minus square root of 6. So, if you have questions or clarifications, pwede nyo pang i-type yung question nyo sa ating comment section. Keep safe and God bless.